नमस्कार सभी को। मैंने अपने सॉल्यूशन के पहले वीडियो के अंदर आप लोगों से सॉल्यूशन का इंट्रोडक्शन और कंसंट्रेशन यूनिट्स के बारे में बात किया था एंड वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट थ्री कंसंट्रेशन यूनिट्स दैट वर स्ट्रेंथ, परसेंटेज कंपोजिशन एंड पार्ट्स पर मिलियन। Now we are taking fourth concentration unit or the next concentration unit, one of the very important concentration unit, molarity. Molarity is denoted by capital M. This concentration unit we are using in our many calculations as well as in practicals, that is of titration. This year you have redox titrations where you have to use molarity calculations to determine concentration in terms of molarity. Okay, so what is molarity? Molarity is number of moles of solute present per liter of solution. Okay, so molarity is defined as number of moles of solute. See, number of moles of solute present per liter of solution. Okay, so mathematically what we can say, molarity is equals to moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. But see, we are not getting any time moles. So moles we have to convert into mass. So what we can say, molarity is equals to mass of solute upon molar mass of solute into, say I am taking volume of solution, and see if I am taking volume of solution in milliliters instead of liters, then on numerator I have to put 1000, because you know 1 liter is equals to how many milliliters? 1000 milliliters. So this is one of the formula which we are using in our calculations sometimes instead of mass of solute, density of solution might have been given. So in that situation, what I can say, density is equals to mass of solution instead of M, I am using word this letter W, mass of solution upon volume of solution. So from here, volume of solution will be equals to mass of solution upon density. And if I put that particular term instead of volume of solution, I will be getting W solute, that is mass of solute, upon molar mass of solute into 1000 upon mass of solution. It should be in grams. Mass of solute should also be in grams into density. So this is one another formula which we are using in our calculations when instead of mass of solution is given and density is given, then in that term we have to use formula molarity is equals to mass of solute upon molar mass of solute into 1000 upon W solution into density. Now we are using molarity equations in our calculations. We have two terms, and these two terms are, number one, molarity equation in dilution process. When I am talking dilution process, say we are having 98% mass by mass, that is around 18 molar 18 molar H2SO4 in the laboratory, and when we want to dilute it, say dilute H2SO4, how we can process that particular dilution process. So we can proceed like this: M1V1 is equals to M2V2. Now suppose we are knowing we have to prepare dilute H2SO4 of suppose 4 molar solution in 5 liters. So this will be 5 liters, this is your 4m, and molarity of concentrated H2SO4, say it is 18 molar. So what volume will be required, we can easily determine, and we can dilute the solution. Another thing, molarity equation, in titration or reactions. This year you have redox titration, last year you had this acid based titration. We are using M1 V1 upon N1 is equals to M2 V2 upon N2, where N1 and N2 are the stoichiometric coefficients of the balanced equation of reactants. Say if I am using your acid based titration, last year you have taken, that was related to dilute HCl and Na2CO3. Twice HCl plus Na2CO3 gives twice NaCl, and for the reaction in that situation we had twice HCl, so 2 HCl and Na2CO3, one mole will be used. Like that we can use this N1 and N2 as the stoichiometric coefficients. What will be the unit of molarity? Unit of molarity will be equals to mole per liter. And one very important thing, yesterday also I told you which concentration units depends upon the temperature. Here molarity also depends upon temperature, because we are taking in terms of volume of solution, and see, volume depends on temperature. So what we can say, molarity is inversely proportional to temperature, and we can say molarity depends upon temperature. Okay, so molarity depends upon temperature. How molarity depends upon temperature? Molarity is inversely proportional to temperature. You can easily understand, if you increase the temperature, volume of solution will increase. When volume of solution will increase, molarity will decrease. If you decrease the temperature, volume of solution will decrease and molarity will increase. So how it depends? If you increase temperature, molarity will decrease. If you decrease temperature, molarity will increase. Molarity inversely proportional to temperature. So these are the facts about the molarity which we are using in our routine calculations. One another thing, that is how molarity and strength are depending on each other. So you can say strength is equals to molarity into molar mass of solute. How strength depends on molarity? Strength is equals to molarity into molar mass. Okay, you can say, what was strength? Strength was mass of solute present per liter of solution. And see, in case of molarity, we have mass of solute upon molar mass. So molar mass to molar mass will cancel, and we will turn this molarity into the strength. Okay, so this is about your concentration unit, molarity, which we are using in our day-to-day life to a large extent in calculations, titrations, experiments, everywhere. Now we are coming to next concentration unit, and the next concentration unit is molality. We are taking next concentration unit, molality, denoted by small m. And molality in some way, it is different from molarity and it is unique in some way. How? We will check with definition. Say molality is number of moles of solute present per kilogram of solvent. What is molality? Number of moles of solute present per kilogram of solvent. Interesting thing you can observe, this is the only concentration unit where we are expressing it in term of mass of solvent. Not mass of solution, we are expressing in term of mass of solvent. So molality denoted by small m. And what is molality? Number of moles of solute present per kilogram of solvent. Or you can say molality is equals to moles of solute upon mass of solvent in kilograms. Now we will convert moles into the mass. So molality will be equals to, say I am taking mass of solute, W solute, upon molar mass of solute into 1000 upon mass of solvent in grams. Say I have used 1000 means kilogram, we have converted into grams. Whenever we have solvent given in grams, we should use this form. Another important thing about the molality, you can say it is in terms of mass of solvent. And when it is in terms of mass of solvent, means mass do not depend upon the temperature, you can say molality do not depend upon temperature. So if someone asks us, out of molality and molarity, which is better concentration unit? We can easily say molality is better concentration expressing unit because it do not depend upon temperature. You keep prepare solution in terms of molality, keep it. If temperature is changing, mass will not change, means molality will not change. So molality is better concentration expressing unit out of molarity and molality. Okay. Another thing, what will be the unit of molality? Unit of molality will be mole per kg. Okay? What will be the unit of molality? Mole per kg. Right? So, molarity, molality. Now we are taking one another important concentration expressing unit, and that is mole fraction. Mole fraction. So mole fraction denoted by small x. Okay. And sometimes it becomes difficult to define mole fraction. How to define mole fraction? I am giving you a very simple trick. Say mole fraction is ratio of number of moles of a particular component to the total number of moles of solution. Say I am taking a solution having two components, component A and component B. Component A and component B. And see, number of moles of component A, say NA. And number of moles of component B, say NB. And if we want to determine mole fraction of A, so XA will be equals to NA number of moles of a particular component Na to the, because we are taking ratio, to the total number of moles, say it is Na plus Nb. And you all know that sum of all the fractions is always equals to 1. What I can say, Xa plus Xb is equals to 1. So Xb will be equals to 1 minus Xa. Okay. So if we want, we know mole fraction of one component, another component's mole fraction can easily be determined. Suppose we have three components, Na, Nb, Nc, then take plus Nc. You can easily determine Xa, then you have to determine then Xb also, and then you will be capable to determine Xc. Okay. Now I am taking, say, Na is equals to mass of A upon molar mass of A. Nb will be mass of B upon molar mass of B. So Xa will be equals to Wa upon Ma upon Wa upon Ma plus Wb upon Mb. Because nobody is going to give you a numerical with moles, you will be getting mass. Say, determine mole fraction of each component of a glucose solution having 10% mass by mass in water. So you can say 10% mass by mass aqueous solution of glucose, mass of glucose will be 10 and mass of water will be 90. You can easily determine that mole fraction. Okay. Another thing I am taking, if solvent is 1000 grams. Okay. And say solvent I am taking B. I am taking B as the solvent. So in that situation, what you can say, Xa will be equals to W. And I am taking this particular term in terms of moles, Na upon Na plus 1000 upon Mb. Interesting thing, I have taken solvent as 1 kilogram. So in that situation, what you can say, this Na will be equals to molality of solution. So sometimes what happens, mole fraction might have been given, mass of solvent might have been given, and question will be given to determine molality. So how to determine molality? Very clear. Xa is given, mass of solvent upon its molar mass. Now Na, because we have taken solvent in term of 1000, that's why you can easily take Na will be equals to molality of the solution. And see, if our solvent is water, if solvent is water, then what you can say, 1000 upon Mb, what is molar mass of water? 18. 1000 upon 18, that comes 55.55. And in that situation, Xa will be equals to Na upon Na plus 55.55. So interesting thing, in case of aqueous solution, if mole fraction is given directly, mole fraction is given directly, say 0.4%, 0.4 is the mole fraction of component, what will be the molality of solution? If simple thing, you put mole fraction 55.55, and then Na will be equals to your molality. Okay. So this is about your mole fraction. In this chapter, this mole fraction will be very useful for us in many other concepts also. Now after mole fraction, I am taking one another concentration unit, that is formality. Determined, denoted by F. And in simple words, if I am say formality, formality is the molarity of ionic solutes. Because for ionic solutes, if I am taking NaCl, for NaCl instead of molar mass, we are using word formula mass. That's why instead of molarity, we will be using formality. So in case of formality, that will be equals to mass of solute upon formula mass of solute into 1000 upon V solution in milliliters. Okay, so this is formality, and see, formality is similar to molarity, only the term changed, that is formula mass instead of molar mass in case of ionic solutes. After formality, one another important concentration unit we are taking, normality. And in normality, many aspects you should learn. Normality denoted by capital N. Nowadays, rarely we are using normality. In most of calculations over an NCERT book and CBSE curriculum, molarity is used instead of normality. But normality is important in many ways. So we will be checking what is normality. Normality is number of gram equivalents of solute present per liter of solution. Number of gram equivalents of solute present per liter of solution. See, in all the concentration units, you have to take care about solute, solution or solvent. In what form you are taking amount of solute and in what form you are taking amount of solution or solvent. Simply you can define the things. Okay. So, normality is equals to number of gram equivalents of solute upon volume of solution in liters. Say in molarity we are taking number of moles, here we are taking number of gram equivalents. Okay, and how to convert gram equivalents into mass or mass into gram equivalent. So another thing I can take, and normality is equals to mass of solute upon equivalent mass. Instead of molar mass, we are using equivalent mass of solute into 1000 upon V solution, volume of solution in milliliters. Okay. How to determine equivalent mass? Molar mass we don't have a problem. We easily determine molar mass. But equivalent mass, how to determine, you should know. And this equivalent mass is very important for the next chapter, that is electrochemistry, where we will have to study Faraday's laws. And when we study Faraday's laws of electrolysis, we have to use this term equivalent mass. So equivalent mass, how to determine? First of all, I am taking equivalent mass of elements. Sodium, potassium, gold, silver, chlorine. That will be equals to molar mass upon valency. If I am determining equivalent mass of sodium, magnesium, gold, silver, Okay, oxygen. What is molar mass of sodium? 23, its valency 1. Magnesium 24, valency 2. Gold 197, valency 3. Silver 108, valency 1. Oxygen 16, valency. This is the first way. Equivalent mass of element. Any element you can determine easily. Calcium, say 40/2. Aluminium, you can take 27/3, like that. Another thing, equivalent mass of oxidizing or reducing agent, that will be equals to molar mass upon change in oxidation number. And I am explaining with very important fact. If we are taking KMnO4, oxidation number of manganese is +7. When it is used as oxidizing agent, acidic medium, neutral medium, basic medium. In acidic medium, it converts into MnO2. In acidic medium, it converts into Mn2+. In neutral medium, it converts into MnO2. And in basic medium, it converts into MnO4-2-. Here oxidation number +2, +4. And here the oxidation number is +6. So change in oxidation number, you can see change is 5. Here change is 3. Change is 1. Molar mass of KMnO4 is 158/5. 158/3. And 158/1. If someone asks, in under what conditions molar mass and equivalent mass of KMnO4 is same, you can easily take in basic medium. Okay. Unit of normality. Its unit will be gram equivalent per liter. And last thing, how molarity and molality are correlated with each other, we can derive it. I am taking normality upon molarity. Normality is mass of solute upon equivalent mass into 1000 upon V. If I am taking molarity, mass of solute upon molar mass into 1000 upon V. See, these terms cancel, mass cancel. We have molar mass upon equivalent mass, or you can say normality is equals to molarity into molar mass upon equivalent mass, or molarity will be equals to normality into equivalent mass upon molar mass. This is all about your normality and concentration expressing units. In next class, we will discuss about vapor, this factors affecting concentration or solubility of the solute in solutions. Thank you.